Yep, that's me. You're probably wondering how I got into this situation. Well, it all started when I didn't subscribe to Crows and watch his YouTube videos about Mordhau. If I did, I probably could have dodged this attack that's coming at me right now. Hey, what is going on everyone, and welcome to a ZWEIHANDER weapons guide for Mordhau. So the ZWEIHANDER is my favorite weapon at the moment, and it has a lot of strengths, honestly, few weaknesses. It's like one of the better weapons in the game, because honestly, in my opinion right now, there's no real OP weapons, like overpowered, except for maybe the, heavy hand axe. But aside from that one, I do think that the weapons are pretty balanced, but there are definitely some that are like worth getting like better with. The ZWEIHANDER is a great example because honestly it's very versatile, and it's very good. Now, disclaimer, I have like 800 hours in Chivalry and like 250 hours in Mordhau because I played since the alpha release back in 2017. So by watching this video, you're obviously not gonna like gain all the skill that I have, but it'll set you on a great path. And I have some like trips, like some tricks and stuff like that that I really wanted to share that I think you could benefit from. So without further ado, I'm gonna get into some of the weaknesses of the weapon. So the main weaknesses, honestly, the first one is that, so it does have a lot of reach. However, that is very bad when you're in like close quarters, because this weapon will hit like walls, trees, rocks, like it'll hit everything. It'll hit your own teammates as well. It's really annoying. Now, you can switch to the alternative grip by pressing R, and you will actually grip the blade of the sword, and the reach will be decreased. However, I don't really find this to be too effective, because even with that grip, the weapon's still very long, so it really doesn't make a difference. I would stay away from the alternative mode altogether, if I'm being honest. I never use it, it's useless, it's just, don't even do it. But it's a pretty small weakness. The other one is that it doesn't quite do the damage that you want it to do, in my opinion. Like, if you're fighting someone with heavy armor, you probably will have to hit them 3 times unless you get headshots. But yeah, that it can be pretty annoying when you come up from people, you know, from behind, and you still have to hit them like 3 times. It's not really a weapon like the Maul or the Executioner sword. It's almost there. It just needs a little bit more damage, but it really can't one-shot a lot of people. So using this weapon as kind of like a backstab weapon is okay, but I'd rather use like the Executioner sword if you were going to like get flanks and just kill people from behind. Because you can one-shot people that are wearing no armor or light armor on their head, and you can one-shot body shot people who are wearing no armor. But other than that, you're gonna have to hit them 2 or 3 times, sometimes even 4 if you stab them in the legs. But yeah, those are basically all the weaknesses. There's one left, and it is that it's not the best weapon for dealing with like fast daggers and stuff, because it's so slow. But then again, like, you can just pretty easily just walk away from daggers and kind of, you know, use your reach to your advantage. So I wouldn't really worry about, you know, getting killed by dagger users too often. So let's talk about some of the strengths, and later on I'm going to talk about like tactics and how I kind of like to use the weapon. But the strengths with this weapon is definitely, first of all, that it's slow. And that might seem like a weakness, but honestly I love that it's slow, because the slower the weapon, the more you can manipulate the swing speed. You can drag it, and what this is basically when you de-accelerate your swing. So basically, let's say that you're swinging from the right. If you look to the right, your swing will be like de-accelerated. It's hard to explain, but I'm gonna make a guide on how dragging works later. But basically, it's very good for catching your opponents off guard, and it's very good into trick people into blocking early, because they're gonna expect a very fast attack, but you're dragging it, so it's a lot slower, so they block early. And that's a very good thing with this weapon, that you're able to do that consistently. Another good thing is that the stabs have such good reach, like it's basically like a spear. And it's also very good for horseback. Like, this is probably the best sword to use while on horseback. For sure, it's a very good horse weapon. Obviously, it's not pole arm, so you're not going to be able to do the special attack, but it's still very effective. The only thing I wouldn't do on horseback is like try to kill other riders if they have a pole arm, because they're going to be at a huge advantage compared to you, so I wouldn't do that. It's also very good for like like 1vxing. So because the sword has a lot of reach and a lot of damage, it's just, yeah, it's very good. Like, a lot of times when I'm using shorter weapons and I'm 1vxing, I'm just finding myself missing a lot of times. I'm like, because when you're 1vxing, you should be like running around a lot and trying to avoid swings, and when you do that, it's pretty easy to like run too far away and then miss your swings. So this weapon is probably like tied with the halberd for like the best 1vx weapon in the game, in my opinion. It is very good for that kind of stuff. It's also very good for killing people who does not have any armor on their head, but I mean, so are most weapons. So lastly, I wanted to bring up some of the tactics that I use when playing with the ZWEIHANDER. It's you can do a lot of stuff with this weapon, but I'd say one easy thing to do that's like very good still is to go for a stab slash morph. So it's basically when you stab first and then you turn it into a like side swing, and then you drag the side swing. It's very good. It really just doesn't like, for so your opponent, the way your opponent sees it is basically he thinks you're gonna throw a fast stab at them, all right? But then you change it to a slow side swing, because the side swings are really slow with the ZWEIHANDER. And then you drag it, so it's even more slow. So it goes from your opponent expecting a fast attack to it being a very, very slow attack. Like one of the slowest in the game, almost. Obviously, more experienced players will expect this a lot more often. But I mean, even I fall for it. A lot of level like 40s and 50s. Fall for it all the time. It's very easy to do, very easy to learn, but you'll dominate like lower level players with this, because you can just do it over and over again and they don't catch on, because it doesn't look right. The animation is pretty wonky, but it's just very good. It's not an exploit, but it's just very easy and like effective. Another thing that's good with the ZWEIHANDER is to kind of like trick people into kind of thinking that you're AFK or something like that. I mean, I do this a lot. Or just looking away, and then kind of when they're close enough to you, you can kind of just look in their general direction and you swing, and you'll probably get a headshot if they're close enough, because the weapon is so long and does so much damage. It's pretty good for doing that. And it's also very good to use on horseback. I mean, I do it a lot, yeah, I really never feel like this weapon has a serious drawback. It's just like, should I use this versus the Executioner sword? That's like the real question. And in my opinion, the ZWEIHANDER is better, simply because it's just more balanced. Like, it's a lot more versatile, because like, the Executioner sword obviously has no stab damage whatsoever. The stabs do very little damage compared to the swings, whereas with the ZWEIHANDER, it's not the same, but the stabs still do pretty similar damage. Like, you can't one-shot people in the head if they're wearing light armor if you stab them. But if you swing their head with the ZWEIHANDER and they are wearing light armor, you will one-shot them. And by the way, I'm sorry if I'm stuttering, but yeah. And the ZWEIHANDER is also longer, and you can combo with the ZWEIHANDER as well. That's a strength, by the way, I forgot to bring up. But yeah, it's a weapon that you're able to combo with. Almost all the swords are, I believe. I think the Executioner sword is the only sword that you can't do combos with. If you don't know what combos are, basically it's when you're able to use swing consecutively and it doesn't get interrupted. An example of a weapon who doesn't combo is the Maul or the Executioner sword, or like the spear, maybe, I'm not sure. So yeah, honestly, the Executioner sword is a lot worse. The only thing it's better for is used to, you know, backstab people, because you can one-shot people in the legs and like in the torso if they're wearing light armor. You can't do that with the ZWEIHANDER. It's not a heavy hitting weapon. It is more of the like a medium caliber sword, I guess, but it's still very good. And if you're looking for a sword to get good with, I really recommend this one. It's very good. So that's about it for this tutorial. I just wanted to like talk about the strengths and weaknesses so that you're aware of them and kind of how like I use the weapon and good tactics that I use. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed, hope you learned something. If you didn't, please like leave a dislike and tell me, you know, what I left out or stuff you want me to bring into videos in the future. And yeah, please comment down below what you want to see next, like maybe a weapon guide for some other weapon. I was thinking of maybe doing the Maul, because I've been playing a lot with the Maul lately, like it's very good. Or like videos like that, or just like playing gameplay videos. Although I find like gameplay videos to in general be pretty dull, but I mean, I'll do them if you guys want them. But yeah, hopefully you like the video, and yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.